It's too late, Mr. Wright. There's not any bar for us now. It looks like he's the one who decided to go through with this one. Can you prove this, Mr. Wright? That the chief, a high-ranking officer of the law, is involved in this murder? Good question. Regardless of his rank or title, Chief Gant is just a man. The question is he a criminal? I believe the evidence will tell. I see. Alright then. So was this evidence that ties Chief Gant to the murder of Detective Goodman? Just remember, it better be good, or I'll have it just here. This is the ID card list. Yes, the one that shows who entered the evidence room on the day of the crime. There is one ID on the list that we couldn't determine the owner of yesterday. 777777. Sorry, but there's no way you can prove that that's my card number. It's your number. What? How do you know that? The safe in Chief's gun office requires a code to open. A 7-digit code. 7 digits? You don't mean. I'm afraid so, Your Honor. The code was 777777. The same as the remaining ID card number of at least. Chief Gant, you entered the evidence room on the day of the crime. We have it now. Order! Order! Chief Gant, what do you have to say? Nothing. The defense search on my office was in violation of regulations. And I will demand Mr. Wright to be punished to the maximum extent of the law. But right now, this court demands an explanation from you about the use of this ID card. Chief Gant, so you admit it? You entered the evidence room? On the day of the crime? What about it? I'm chief of police, whether it's the evidence room or the bathroom. What's the difference? I can go wherever I go. Tell me, when you enter the room, were you alone? I always go to the bathroom alone, as I do with the evidence room. Jeffrey Goodman wouldn't have happened to be with you that day, would he? On the bathroom? No, why would he? Of course not, why would he? I hadn't seen him in days. You haven't seen him in days, Chief Gant? I'm afraid you've just undone yourself. On that day, you had to have met with Detective Goodman. What do you mean? This trial's purpose is to determine Lana Sky's guilt. No, it isn't, Your Honor. The trial's purpose is to determine the truth. If Chief Gant met the victim on the day of the crime, then we need to determine one thing. What transpired during that meeting? In that case, Mr. Wright, I'm going to have to ask you for evidence. Show us proof that the victim went to meet Chief Gant on the day of the crime. Sure. No, that's here, sorry. No, there's got to be something more solid than this. What? Oh. Yep, that's the next one. I'm sorry. Regardless, you see what the Deputy Goodman the day? Yeah, I made my first honest to goodness mistake. Good job, Leonida. Oh, now I remember. The Deputy Goodman lost his ID card on the day of the crime. Or to be more accurate, Jake Marshall stole it. So the Deputy Goodman filled out a lost item report. He would have to give that report to the chief of police. Yet you are in possession of this report, which means you can't be sure he filled it. He filled it. How do I know, you ask? Because he needed to enter the evidence room that day. Yes, to transfer the evidence out. Oh. So David Goodman took the phone to you, Chief Gant. Then you accompanied the detective to the evidence room. I accompanied him. There's another way the murderer and Detective Goodman could have entered the room. Hold on, let me guess what you're going to say next. I, the chief of police, murdered Pooh Goodman. Exactly. But wait, The chief didn't necessarily need to accompany him in the courtroom, in the evidence room. He could have just lent him his ID card. Yes. Now that you mention it, I believe I might have done something of the sort. Sorry, but that's not possible. According to the record, your card was used only once. But you so lost your ID card earlier. If you had really lent it to Goodman, it wouldn't have been found on his body. It would have been found. No! Chief Gant, you didn't. The murder was most likely committed on the spur of the moment. No one in their right mind would choose the police department as a place to commit murder. After the murder, he contacted Lana at the prosecutor's office. Why else to dispose of Detective Goodman's body? However, the victim's body was discovered in the prosecutor's office parking lot. How did he manage to move it there? I was at the police department the entire day, you know. And everyone's aware that Lana stayed at the prosecutor's office after the ceremony. Everyone except me, it seems. Still, you're the chief of police. You have an entire police force at your disposal. So, you think I just ordered an officer to do it? Hey, you, take this here dead body over to the prosecutor's office. I don't think so. Chief Gant, you left all the evidence we need to prove how you moved the body to the prosecutor's office. And all this time I thought it was a useless clue just taking up space. Yeah, you know what it is, I'm sorry for this. Mr. Wright, show us this evidence. To move the victim's body, Chief Gant used this. Well, it's right there. This is how he moved Detective Goodman's body. A parking stab? Miles Edgeworth? You mean... The body was found in the track of Mr. Edgeworth's car. I think it's obvious that what happened. The body was moved by that car. You mean I carried the victim's body? Precisely so. But wait, even you know, I didn't plan on returning to my office after the ceremony finished that day. But you did return. Tell me why. I was asked to go, by Chief Gant no less. He told me he wanted me to keep a screwdriver in the prosecutor's office. In any case, on the day of the incident, I brought this to the prosecutor's office. So you see, what you really took to the prosecutor's office wasn't the screwdriver, but the victim's body in your trunk. Detective Goodman's body was carried in the trunk of the Mr. Edgeworth's car? Yes, unless of course you have another explanation, Chief. Why else would you have asked Mr. Edgeworth to carry evidence from a closed case? There's only one plausible explanation. To transport the body of your accomplice, Mrs. Lana Sky. Order, order, order! What's going on here? Is there no room for acquittal to the defense's outrageous accusations? Think back to this photograph Mrs. Lana took at the prosecutor's office. There was not a photo of the body being stuffed in the trunk to be taken away. It was exactly the opposite. It is a photo of the body being taken from the trunk. Chief Gant, please say something. I believe... Your time is up. My time is up? Sorry, Raito, but I'm having lunch with the District Attorney General after this. We have to get going if we're really going to... If we're to make it in time for the early bird special. But the cross-examination isn't finished yet. Remember what I told you earlier? A police chief has all kinds of weapons at his disposal. Weapons? Like the right to refuse to testify. I'm invoking that right now. What? That is a right to be counselly invoked. But isn't a right to be invoked. There are certain risks to be considered. So you're going to just run away after all this? Run away? Don't make me laugh, Worthy. I stumbled, Goodman. That's what you're saying right now. But if you had any conclusive evidence, you would have presented it by now. Well, I... You think I had Lana dispose of the body? If so, then so you're proved and get over with it. I'll say it again, Mr. Ike. Damon Gant is the current chief of police. The court will not tolerate any accusations against him without concrete proof. Well, Mr. Wright, Your Honor? Do you have any concrete proof? Proof that Chief Gant murdered Detective Goodman and made Mrs. Kennedy dispose of the body. Do I have any concrete proof? Unfortunately, I don't. It's no use showing evidence if I'm not even sure of it myself. No, Your Honor, at present, I have no conclusive evidence. Sorry. Ha! See, Algy? If that's the case, the court is forced to penalize you for your allegations against the chief. What? Don't gamble against unless the stakes are high. It seems that Lady Luck was on my side today. Okay, Algy, I'll leave the rest to you. I warned you earlier, Mr. Wright. This is an effort to a senior officer of in our nation's law of... Well, what? Objection. Lady Luck, Maybe you should have a word with her. Mr. Resort, what do you mean? There's one lady who knows the real truth behind this trial. We haven't yet had the honor of hearing her testimony. The lady who knows the truth. Another witness. In the absence of conclusive evidence, the only other method of proof is testimony. But Chief Gant has invoked his right to refuse to testify. There's still someone else, one more witness who can answer all questions raised in this trial. Someone right in this very room. Right, do you understand who I'm talking about? Why are you asking me, Your Honor? Have you forgotten? The defense is the one calling witnesses today. Don't you understand what I'm talking about, right? Mr. Wright, does such a witness exist? She may not be willing to tell the truth. But we can't stop now. Yes, Your Honor. The defense calls forth. The defendant? Miss Lana Sky? She was in the underground parking lot at 5:15 on February 21st. Helped us to dispose of the victim's body. In accordance with a certain summons order. Mr. Edgeworth, the prosecution has no objections, Your Honor. Very well, the court will now take its final recess for the day. In 15 minutes, we will reconvene to hear the defendant's testimony. This court is now in re. Hold on. Huh? Chief Gant, I thought you were going to eat. Listen good, Lana. He's talking to Lana. I don't think you need me to tell you this, but if you accept Mr. Wright's claim, there will be terrible consequences. That's right. Your sister will be found guilty of Neil Mass's murder. Of course, you'd never support such outrageous claims anyway, right? Just something to think about. All right then. I've got to lunch day to meet. Okay. If there aren't any further objections, this court is now in recess. Whew, this is not going well. I'm sorry. Looks like we managed to stay in the game. Yeah, thanks to your help, Edgeworth. That chief, he's something else. Apples? Detective Gamsu! Haha, it's not a detective anymore. Oh, yeah, sorry about that. Don't worry. I've already decided where to work now. At your office! My office? Yeah, do you know any magic? Or something? Sure! I'll take on the place of that top-notched girl you used to work with. Could he mean Maya? Can you channel spirits? Looks like we're all out of moves now. Chief Gunn's done it again. How is it he always gets the upper hand? It's not fair he has the right to refuse to testify. Settle down, right? Remember what the judge said. But Chief, that is not the right to be casually invoked. There are certain risks to be considered. Risks? What did he mean by that? It's simple. If the chief refuses to testify, the opposite also holds true. You mean he forfeits his right to say anything too? Yo, Emma! Are you okay? Yeah, when I came to, I was in the medical office. I've been listening to the trial from the gallery. So she has heard everything that, that's been going on. Emma, I'm sorry for what I said before. No, don't be. It was the truth. Sorry for that, something happened. No, don't be, it was the truth. You know, it's funny, I almost feel somehow relieved.
Relieved?
Yeah, now I finally know what really happened. To think that all this time, my sister was being blackmailed by that terrible man. And she did it all just to protect me. Ever since her appointment as chief prosecutor, everyone who knows her said she changed. Perhaps it was easier that way for her. What do you mean? What do you think I mean? To follow Chief Gunn's order? She must have shut herself up deep inside. To force herself to do anything and everything the chief told her to do. That must be why she became so cold. It was all my fault. It's all because I murdered Mr. Muscle. Hey, don't go blaming yourself now. If you want to blame anyone, blame society. Huh? Chief Gunn may be able to fool everyone else with his forgery, but he can't fool my memory. I remember now. I knocked Mr. Muscle into that armor. I see. Well, we better get back. It's time for the final act. Emma, why don't you wait here? No. I'm going with you. I want to be there. Then Lana tells the truth. Let's go, right. It's time to end this.